We continue our look into Sympy, and we're going to deal with limits in this video lecture. As per usual, in my first block of code, I'm going to import Sympy as this abbreviation SYM, so I have to refer to it. One of its functions there, init underscore printing, open and close parenthesis, and I'm setting, as per usual, the variable x as a symbol. Limits quite easy. Here we have uppercase L. You might imagine that this is just going to do the printing for us as opposed to doing the calculation. It goes into opening and closing parentheses, and it takes three arguments here. I've used three arguments here. It is my expression first, comma, and then the variable of the limit, and then what the limit is approaching, the value that it approaches. So here I have the sine of x over x. But because I only imported Sympy in this fashion, later on I'll show you other ways to do this, I have to refer to Sympy or the abbreviation that I've saved here. So sim.sin of x over x. And let's execute this block of code and look at that. So the printing is going to be done like this, 1 over x times the sine of x, which you can just obviously imagine is sine of x over x. But look at the beauty here, the limit as x approaches 0 of the sine of x over x. As per usual, there's more than one way to do the actual calculation. Yeah, I'm still stuck with the uppercase L, so it would just invoke the pretty printing for me. But I have the dot do it section here at the end, open and close parenthesis, and if I do that, it'll actually do the limit for me. So the solution to this limit is 1. The limit as x approaches 0 of the sine of x over x being 1. Now, we can execute it in a second manner. Here we've just used do it with the capital L, but as with integral and integrate, I have the lowercase l here as in limit, and that is just going to do the calculation for me. Indeed, the solution to this limit is 1. Now, I just want to introduce to you the infinity symbol, and that's quite easy to do in Sympy. I'm going to have sym dot capital L limit, uppercase L, so that's just going to do the printing for me, 1 over x, as x approaches infinity, the infinity symbol is 2 lowercase o's, so just the o on the keyboard, but I have to refer to Sympy first to do that, so it's Sympy, sym dot double o, and lo and behold, there's a beautiful infinity symbol there, so the limit as x approaches infinity of 1 over x. I'm going to execute this code to look for an answer by using the lowercase l in this instance, and I have the solution to this limit being 0 as we know. Now, is it really 0? Indeed, we can look at the left and right hand sides as we approach the limit from the left and the right hand side. So here I'm just going to print this limit. I'm saying 1 over x, and remember here in this instance of IPython notebook, I'm using Python 2.7.6. So if, perhaps not important here, but just to remind us all of the fact that you have to put this dot after the one so that this one is not seen as an integer. It's not the point here. It's 1 over x as x approaches 0 from the right-hand side. So another argument, I now have one argument, two argument, three argument, fourth argument. So after the third comma, I have a fourth argument. DIR for direction equals, and then in single or double quotes, I use single quotes, plus there, so I'm approaching it from the right-hand side. So when I print this out, you can't actually see anything, other than the fact that this one is now represented as a floating point value instead of represented as an integer, so we see the 1.0. So in the printing, we're not going to have anything here. But now I'm going to execute it. I've used the uppercase L there, so I've got to have the dot do it if I want it to be executed. So if I run that, we see approaching the limit from the right-hand or positive side now gives me infinity. And I can also approach it from the left-hand side by putting a negative there as my fourth argument, DIR equals, and then in quotes, a negative sign. And if I run that, approaching the limit from the left-hand side or the negative side is negative infinity. Just on the matter of infinity, how to refer to negative infinity in your code in Sympy. And here we have 1 over x squared, just make things a bit interesting. Doesn't matter, and if x goes to negative, so that negative sign doesn't go there. It's not sim dot negative oo. It's negative sym dot oo. And if we execute that code nicely, the limit as x goes to negative infinity of 1 over x squared. So that's a look at limits, prints beautifully, and can be calculated very easily.